next, we'll have your local forecast, but right now it's...
Oh, it is.
The airline is United.
Hey, Memorial. I'm Ryan Burns.
And I'm Kelly Walker, and this is NBC, the 7133.
And
I'm Reese Weir.
And welcome to the April episode of the NBC 713. Reese, have you heard of the construction they're doing here at Memorial next year?
No, I haven't heard anything about it.
Let's take a look.
Hey guys, I'm Sophia Trefilio, and I'm here with Ms. Weir to talk about MHS construction. So what are the current plans for phase one of construction?
Phase one is well underway right now. It's going to be a new building that was approved by the bond of 2017 that was passed. And it's going to be a new academic wing that's really going to be housed on the current tennis courts. The first thing that's going to happen is we're going to rebuild the tennis courts over by the baseball field across from Echo Lane, really across from Spring Ranch Middle School on that back side of the baseball field. So they're going to relocate all the tennis center over there. And then where the existing tennis courts, they're going to build up a new, hopefully a four-story building, and it'll be a new academic wing, and also have a new cafeteria unit.
Great, that's really interesting. So when do you think the construction will start?
I would say late summer, early fall, and then I would probably estimate maybe we break ground on the new building maybe in January or so. And then at the end of total phase one project, then the Aqua building will come down, and the Violet building will come down, Silver will come down, and so it'll look a lot different.
Okay, and what effect will that have on the students?
Hopefully it won't be very disruptive to the student body at all by the way that we're doing this. So I think, you know, next year we will lose those T-Shacks 5, 6, 7, and 8 that are right behind, you know, where the dumpsters are. Those will be gone, so we won't have those next year. But we'll still have all that parking that we have now. The students will have all their same parking that they have now, so it shouldn't interrupt really the students at all.
Okay. Well, that's great to know. I know that a lot of the juniors were concerned about their parking.
Yeah, I would assume that we do the same junior lottery that we've always done. We're still going to park in church for that. The juniors are there now, and so the seniors will still have all the surface level parking, and that shouldn't be disrupted at all.
Great. And when do you think phase one will be complete?
They say it's about a two-year build, so I would say if we start building in January of, 2020, then we would probably move into the new space in January of 2022, possibly. So it'll take a couple of years to get that all done.
Okay, well, thank you so much for talking with
us. You bet.
Here at Memorial, Mustangs are encouraged to live by the Mustang way. Let's take a look at what it's really about.
And there's a fire that I will say. There's a fire by the fire brigade.
What morality means to me is to know the difference between right and wrong. For example, not cheating on a test and studying very hard for it.
Understanding to me is to take into account people's emotions and how they feel. At school, I would probably be understanding if one of my friends started crying over homework and I helped them.
To me, spirit means just being excited about school events and having pride. And being here at Memorial, I've just learned how to have a lot of spirit. It's really encouraging to other people.
Who prefers to showing integrity and being honest all the time? Telling the truth can be just being honest in all types of situations.
Appreciation. I appreciate, you know, what other people have to say, whether it's in a class where they raise their hand and contribute to whatever the teacher's talking about.
Noteworthiness is how credible someone is, and in school it's how like trustworthy you are and how much you like work to your goals. I can show noteworthiness by trying my hardest and my best at everything I do.
Grit to me is working really hard at something. Even if you don't succeed the first time, you keep going and going to reach a specific goal that you set for yourself. An example is like, if you want to make the basketball team or a football team, whatever you're playing, and you're not very good, you just work hard and harder until you make the team, because that's the goal that you set for yourself.
Self-respect is making choices that better yourself and your life. You can have self-respect by like giving myself a pat on the back.
Take pride in our academics. Here's a look at AP test prep and college prep.
I've been using Khan Academy and I like to do unit reviews. So I will look over the notes for each unit and try to reorganize them.
My Princeton Review textbooks and with a tutor.
To prepare, I take a lot of diligent notes in class. Listening to the teacher is always important. And then reading the textbook and any other like outside information that you can find is also useful.
I like to go over the review books. I go over my notes, but I also like to study with my friends because it really helps when you're surrounded by other kids who are taking the same AP courses as well.
I would say just it's because I think AP classes, you have to stay constantly focused for each unit. So as long as you know what you're doing all year long, you don't really need to review that much.
Start studying way ahead of the time, ahead of the game. That way you don't have to stress out the night before or the week before.
I think the best prep for AP is paying attention in class and going to all the practice things that they offer.
Pay attention in class, have your notes ready, and be confident when you're taking the exam.
I like to use Princeton Review, and I think Barron's is really good for A push.
I use Five Steps for Five and the Princeton Review.
I only use review books for classes that are needed, like chem or like music theory, and I use Five Steps to a Five, which is really good.
I study studying during the spring break.
I start studying typically when the class starts, so I keep up with chem, with unit one, and so on and so forth.
Since I have five APs this year, I would start about a month before the AP exams.
I like to listen to music and just do some exercise.
I don't handle my stress, and I just don't sleep and study for APs.
To de-stress before an exam, I try to take a breather 5-10 minutes before the exam, just stay positive. If you go in thinking you're going to pass, you're most likely going to pass. If you go in with a bad mentality, thinking you're going to fail, you're most likely not going to do so well.
To de-stress, I usually just try to get as much sleep as I can.
I cuddle with my dog and eat a lot.
What I think is really important for the kids to do and is most helpful is to do a practice test where they actually see questions like they're going to get on an AP exam. And then the really important thing is going over it after you take the exam. I find that after we go over an exam and we look at the right answers and why they were the right answer, if the kids have time to take a second test, they'll do so much better. And the free response questions, the kids can find them on the College Board website. They're all released. But honestly, your teacher, it's his job or her job to be an expert on the exam. Listen to what your teacher says.
I'm Ms. Turner, and I'm a counselor here at Memorial High School. I'm the Alpha Split Co through GO, CO through GO.
I'm Ms. Johnson, and I have students with last names A through CL.
So Naviance is pretty much a tool that helps you with the college application process. You can go on there and create a resume. You can go on there and add schools to your colleges I'm applying to list. You won't be able to do that until the end of summer when you're actually a senior. And then from there, your teachers can send letters of recommendations to your colleges, and we can send your transcripts that way as well. So brag sheets and resumes are important for parking because everyone wants parking. So you need to do your student brag sheet, which is on the homepage of the Naviance webpage. You'll see it on the bottom right. It's assigned by Mr. Nickerson. So the student brag sheet you do on Naviance, the parent brag sheet you'll find on a counselor's website in the resources section. There's a section for juniors, and at the bottom you'll find the parent brag sheet. For a resume, you can create your own if you have one already, or you can just do it through Naviance. There's a quick checklist that you go through, and Naviance helps you create that.
And the more detailed it is, the better it is for us. Sometimes juniors tend to see this as just a task to get through so that you can get parking for senior year. But we actually look at those brag sheets and those resumes because a lot of colleges ask us to write letters on behalf of the student for colleges. So for internships and moving forward, if you go to the school counseling website, underneath special programs, there is a link that you can click on that will take you out to program finders for internships in particular. The really internships are on the student to be able to find what it is that you need in an internship. That's really on you to look for those things and those opportunities. You might start with some of your parents, maybe their locations where they work, their bosses, things like that, and see if they're hiring for the summer or if they would take on an intern. Or you could just get a regular summer job, whether it's at Kroger or Baskin Robbins. Colleges tell us that they like to see a strong work ethic mm-hmm. that's been built into a student, so regular jobs would be fine as well.
Mm-hmm. And some other activities you can do during the summer. You have your mission trips, you have volunteer activities. Summer camps are a good place for you to volunteer. And another thing you want to work on in summer is your college essay. So Apply Texas opens, I believe it's July 1st. So you can go on there. Your application isn't due July 1st, so don't freak out. You can just go on there and see what the application is about. And then you can work on your essay. Find something that you really like to do, stick to it. Be invested in it and just sell that when you apply to colleges.
It is a stressful time applying to all of these schools and thinking there's so many things you got to get done over the summer, but just take a breath, make a to-do list. Those often help. We're here to help you. Counselors come back early in the summer, so you can always reach out to your counselor if you need help or have a quick question. Other than that, just relax. It'll be okay. There is a school out there for everyone, and we're here to help you in that process.
Have a great summer.
Have a great summer.
Reese, do you play any spring sports?
No, Laura, do you?
No.
Okay, let's take a look at those who do.
Get money addict, I'ma get money tatted. Money in the attics, money in the stashes. Money in the cabinets, stuffed in the mattress. Safe full of guns, more money up in that shit. Taz on Tisa, Jeremy Scott Adidas. Mason Martin Margiela, three strap sneakers. Riding with a leecher, student and a teacher. It's money over, no room for a skeezer. Thinking of a Lambo, bathing a camo.
Hey Mustangs, it's Ellis Nasdale, and today we're going to be giving you information about the track and cross country programs we have here at Memorial.
Hi, my name is Coach Cooprider. I coach girls track. It's a great sport because there's so many different events. No matter what abilities you have, whether you're fast at short distances or you have a little bit more stamina, or maybe you're a more power explosive athlete, there's going to be an event for you. As you get built into the program, you're going to start to see that it is competitive, and so we have to be prepared to represent ourselves well. We are a no-cut sport, but we still have rules and we still have procedures that we want all of our athletes to follow. And track doesn't start until the spring, so technically we kind of start officially in January, but we have eighth period athletics every day starting in August. You're doing a more intense 50-minute training from beginning of school all the way until first semester ends.
My name is Hunter Hardy. I'm a senior and I've been on varsity track since freshman year. My main event is pole vaulting, and my favorite part about track is that you can really see yourself improve as time goes on.
Hi, my name is Andy Rice. I've been in the track program for 4 years. I've been on varsity for 3 of those years. I throw shot put and discus. My shot put PR is 52 feet 7 inches, and my discus PR is 158. And then I've thrown quite recently 172.2.
My name is Catherine Stiles. I'm a 10th grader. I run hurdles, and I've been in track for a year.
on top of track, I do dance, and the reason I wanted to do track was just because it sounded something fun, and the girls have like a great connection.
This April, there's been a lot going on here around campus at Memorial. Here's a better look into it.
Hi, I'm Hannah Landa.
And I'm Sarah Jane.
And we're going to tell you about Future Farmers of America,
also known as FFA.
Hi, I'm Leela Chang, and I'm a part of FFA.
Hi, I'm Ava Chang, and I'm in FFA.
Hey, everybody, my name's Dare Lovett, and I'm a member of the Spring Branch FFA.
I'm Andy Valachek. I'm a junior at Memorial High School, and I'm in Spring Branch FFA.
I raised turkeys this year. I actually had 15 turkeys.
This year I raised a goat. I've raised a lamb, chickens, rabbits, and a pig.
This year I had a market steer and I had a pen of 50 broiler chickens.
Look at all those chickens!
I got grand champion with my rabbits and fifth place with my pig, and I also got grand champion showmanship with my pig.
My turkeys placed grand champion this year, so first place.
And I placed first in my class, middleweights.
My steer, I got second in my heavyweight class, and third overall. With my broilers, I got third overall.
It's definitely not as hard as raising like a cow or a steer, but there were some challenges that came with it, but it was fun, so.
Well, it's definitely harder. You got to get up about an hour and a half earlier than everybody else to go out every morning and take those animals. So you are the one feeding, training, caring for, and cleaning those animals. But in the end, it's a big payout.
My family has two ranches, and my brother's been at FFA, and it's kind of something that I just got thrown into, and I've loved every minute of it.
I really want to become a vet, so.
I joined FFA because I went to one of their shows and I really liked it, so I wanted to raise my own animal.
I had a family ranch that I used to spend some time on, but I really wanted to know how everything actually worked in the real world.
An egg on their head.
I'm Kate
Burrow. I'm Jacob Absher.
And I'm Jonathan Stukley.
And we're cracking eggs on our head.
I got the horses in the back. Horse stock is a class. Got the horses like a man. Riding on a horse. You get with your horse. I've been in the valley. You ain't been up off that porch. Can't nobody tell me nothing.
This is like yellow sprinkles in it. Like birthday cake.
This is like red. Yeah. It's like cherry or strawberry.
It is.
This is like brown. So. That's like cinnamon. Right?
This one's like, oh, that's so gross. Tan. I don't know what that is. It's like chocolate.
This is like tan, darker bottom. So
that's what she spit out. Good. Chocolate.
We're gonna try the pink and blue one first.
It tastes like cotton candy.
Yeah. Okay, I'm doing this one. It's like that. What the? There's like it's s'mores. It has to be. Wait. Yeah.
I'm trying this pink and green one. It tastes like apples. Like sour apples.
Or watermelon. I'm trying the white one with chocolate on the bottom.
Is that coconut? Is it coconut?
Yeah.
Disgusting. I don't like coconut. Ew!
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
What's up, Memorial? It's Ron Swankowski, and today we're going to be looking at the beautiful landscapes around our school and talking about Earth Day.
Earth Day was a kind of national awareness day towards environmental protection that got started back in the 1970s with the whole idea being to bring awareness to Earth, the plight, and what human activities are doing to kind of damage our ecosystem and the habitat that we're in.
Earth Day is a day for all of us to celebrate Mother Nature and really give back to our environment and try to preserve it in any way that we can.
Earth Day is a day where you celebrate and appreciate Mother Nature.
That is going to be by far burning of fossil fuels for energy. Close number two is actually greenhouse gas emissions, including methane from agriculture, cows, basically. But far and away, the biggest thing that's contributing to pollution is definitely burning of fossil fuels for energy.
So the biggest contributing factor to pollution is probably the burning of fossil fuels. So that could be burning coal or petroleum.
Straws from that kill turtles. I'm kidding. It's actually planes and cars.
Basically, if the number one thing is going to be burning the fossil fuels, do anything you can do to reduce that. Instead of driving a car everywhere by yourself, maybe carpool, ride a bike, take mass transport. Another big thing you can do is actually change your diet. The lower you eat on the food chain and the more kind of vegetarian friendly your meals are, the lower the environmental impact is going to be. And that's for a large number of reasons.
So a really big factor to help our environment is, number one, preserve your energy. So things like turning off the lights when you leave or turning off the heater, that can save a lot of energy and not be as wasteful.
I am walking to school instead of driving so I don't pollute the air, because I keep getting towed, actually.
It's usually the last Monday of April, but it's late in April.
Earth Day is April 22nd, one day before my birthday.
As you know, Brooke and Christina are leaving for college.
So let's take a look back at our memories all together.
Hold on to me as we go, as we roll down this unfamiliar road. And although this wave is stringing us along, just know you're not alone, 'cause I'm gonna make this place your home. Settle down, it'll all be clear.
gonna make this place your home.
That's it for today, Mustangs. For NBC, where horsepower drives the news, I'm Laura Shepherd.
I'm Reese Weir.
Have a great day.